Welcome back, you guys. Glenn with Old School Millennial. Today I'm going to be talking about one of my favorite subjects, and that's chainsaws. I'm going to be trying to answer the question, which chainsaw should I buy? So when you're looking at chainsaws, it can be a little bit overwhelming for somebody that is just getting into using chainsaws, and everything is all dependent on what your uses for the chainsaws are, obviously. So when looking at chainsaws for a homeowner, I'm thinking about the tasks that a homeowner might use those chainsaws for. So a fallen branch, maybe a tree fell on your property, but it's a one-off thing and you're gonna be bucking that up. When looking at that type of chainsaw, I'm gonna be thinking about like entry-level chainsaws. So in this video, I'm mainly gonna be speaking about the two main brands of chainsaws, and that is Stihl and Husqvarna. So one great entry-level chainsaw is the Stihl MS-170 and the MS-180. This is the MS-180. This is a great chainsaw for limbing, for cutting up smaller trees, kind of an all-around just smaller saw, mainly for limbing. I'm gonna say this is where this chainsaw really shines, but it's a great chainsaw. It can be used a lot of the time if you're a homeowner, and if you're working with firewood, it also can help on some of the smaller limbs and stuff. But this is what I would like point you towards on an entry-level chainsaw as a homeowner. Another choice, if you're looking at Husqvarna, they make the Husqvarna 235, which is comparable to that MS-180 style chainsaw. I've never used it, but I hear good things about it, but I'm just speaking from experience. The 180 works as a great limbing chainsaw. Now, if you're cutting firewood every once in a while, you probably want to jump up maybe to the MS-250, which is also a great chainsaw. A smaller chainsaw, but a little bit more power if you're cutting a little bit more often. Now, this is kind of where you make the jump up to bigger chainsaws. So one thing to think about, if you're heating your home with firewood, this is where we start to jump up a little bit. If you're heating your home with firewood, I'm going to suggest that you have a couple chainsaws, at least two chainsaws if you're heating your home with firewood. And depending on how much you're cutting, you might stick with that MS-180 as like your smaller chainsaw. Then I would start to point you towards what are called the farm and ranch style chainsaws. So on Stihl's end of the spectrum, you're looking at the MS-271, the MS-291, and then on the Husqvarna side of things, you're looking at the Husqvarna 450 Rancher, or they have a 455 Rancher and the 460 Rancher. If you're heating your home with firewood, that will help you buck the bigger logs and cut those up into firewood blocks. And then you'll have the smaller chainsaw, like a 180 or a Husqvarna 235 as your smaller chainsaw. And that's really if you're getting into cutting firewood to heat your home. So I've spoken about homeowners. I've spoken about homeowners that are heating with firewood. Now I'm going to be speaking about landowners. So as a landowner, if you want to be able to cover most of the things that will come your way, I'm going to say you're going to want to have three different chainsaws. So I'm just going to speak about the CCs that you're looking at. So the three different chainsaws I would point you towards is to have a 30cc chainsaw, a 50cc chainsaw, and a 70cc chainsaw. And in the chainsaw forums and the people that do a lot of research on chainsaws, that's called a chainsaw plan. And that's a 30, 50, 70. Some people do a two chainsaw plan as a 50, 70. And I might do a video later on about pairing chainsaws, and that way you can have the maximum amount of capabilities. As far as using a 30, 50, and a 70, I'll speak towards Stihl first. So a couple chainsaws that you might look at, again, the 180 as your smaller chainsaw. As a landowner, You can use the farm and ranch chainsaws. They'll work great for you. If you want to jump up a little bit as far as in capability, you want to look towards the pro chainsaws. So for Stihl, that's the MS-261. So the MS-261 is a great all-around chainsaw. And for those of you that have seen some of my other videos, I've done a couple of videos on this chainsaw, and I'll put a link to those so that you can check those out if you're interested. But this is a good all-around chainsaw. This will take care of most of your needs as a landowner on a property. Now, where you're gonna run into wanting slightly different sizes of chainsaws is where you're running into either a lot of smaller wood or you're trying to clear a ton of brush. It's kind of nice to have that MS-180 on the Stihl side of things. And that being said, the 261 doesn't really weigh that much. So if you can handle a 261, you may not need that smaller chainsaw. So from there, as a landowner, I'm gonna suggest that you have one bigger chainsaw. And I like to spread my chainsaws a little bit further out. So I go from a 50 to a 70 there. If you're looking at Stihl brand, they make a 462, which is an awesome saw from everything that I hear about it. It's a very light chainsaw and it's something that's very capable. If you had those three chainsaws, you could cover everything that you would need to on a property and do it very quickly. You'd be able to buck, you'd be able to fell trees and limb them, no problems. With that being said though, if you just want to buy one chainsaw, I would point you towards that MS-261 if you just want a chainsaw to cover all of your bases. So on the Husqvarna side of things, using that same 30, 50, 70 mindset, find a 30cc chainsaw. They make a 235, I think they make a 240. In the middle of the pack, you've got, as far as the 50cc's, as I mentioned earlier, you've got the 450, the 455, and the 460 ranchers. Great saws. If you wanna bump up your capability, you're gonna want to jump up to the 550. So this is the Husqvarna 550 Mark II. This is their latest chainsaw, latest 50cc chainsaw, just like the latest one from Stihl is this 261. This saw, as I mentioned on the 261, this saw can handle most of your needs as a landowner. It will limb, it will buck trees, and you can also fell trees with this chainsaw. From there, you can jump up to the 70cc class. And on the Husqvarna side of things, there's really two main chainsaws that I would point you towards. If you like the carbureted style, older style chainsaws, I'll point you to the 372. And then if you're looking for what's called the auto-tune feature, then you can jump onto the 572, which is Husqvarna's latest and greatest technology. So as you can see, I have the 372, and this is a great workhorse of a chainsaw. This can handle everything on my property. So from there, it just goes down to personal preference. I mean, do you like a lighter chainsaw that you can use for limbing all the time, and maybe it's powerful enough to buck with as well? Or do you like that bigger chainsaw that you can put a longer bar on it and you're not having to bend down as much? A lot of people enjoy that type of chainsaw, and I understand that definitely helps a lot. With that 372, it's nice to not to have to bend down as much to cut and buck with. And really, I mean, if you can handle it, that 70cc chainsaw can do everything that the smaller chainsaws can do. It's just about how much you can lift and how long you can hold it. Also from there, if you are a landowner, oftentimes you might wanna sell some of that firewood that you have on your property. As someone that wants to sell firewood, you're gonna at least wanna have two chainsaws. The first two chainsaws that I would point you towards would be a 50cc and a 70cc. That should cover most of what you'll need to run into. You can buck with that, you can limb with that. If you can just have two chainsaws, those are good sizes to have and cover most of what you're gonna run into. But if you're gonna be selling firewood, you may want something a little bit bigger than that 50cc chainsaw. So look at some of those 70cc chainsaws, even 80, there's some 80cc chainsaws and even 90cc chainsaws. It's nice on those really bigger trees, and I'm gonna say in excess of 24 inches to look at those nice 90cc chainsaws. So on the Husqvarna side, that's the 390 and the 395. Great chainsaws. On the Stihl end of the spectrum, some of those chainsaws, like they have a new Stihl 79cc chainsaw that is the Stihl 500i, which I've heard really good things about, and then the Stihl 661, which has been around for a little while. Thanks for joining me today, you guys. As you can tell, I love chainsaws and I love talking about them and researching about them. So if you all have any questions that you think I can answer, put them down in the comments. And I appreciate you guys, all the support on the channel. If y'all like videos like this, don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and hit that bell notification so that you can be notified whenever I post up new videos. And if y'all want to, put down in the comments what chainsaws y'all use. I really enjoy hearing what different people use and why, and maybe the types of trees that they're cutting and kind of the situation that they're using them for, because that's how we all learn you know, more about the capabilities of these different chainsaws. And again, I just enjoy talking about them. Until next time, you guys, get outside and do something you love. Thanks.